Hello, hello! Welcome to the House of Witchcraft. I'm Taryn S., a high priestess in an American witchcraft tradition with over 35 years in our magical community. First thing I want to say to you is to all you newbie witches out there, welcome home. So good to see you. Now, for you newbie witches, this video may be a little more than what you're looking for. If you are still in your first year or two, there are probably other books out there that are better for you to read so that you can really get into whatever tradition you're involved in or as a solitaire learning the basis of magic. What I want to talk about is, where the heck are the advanced witchcraft books? I've done read all the 101 books, the same information over and over again. Why aren't there any advanced witchcraft books? Actually, there are lots of them, but they have actually very little to do with witchcraft. Yeah, I know, sort of confusing, isn't it? You're like, what do you mean, Taryn? Well, what happens is, during your foundation, your formulative knowledge base, you start becoming interested in a particular subject, okay? I've pulled some books here, and so I'm going to go through them so I can explain what I'm talking about. All right, you've started, you're wanting to know more about these older incantations, older workings, older spells. You're wanting to learn the roots of it. Where is this coming from? It's folk magic. One of the best books in America is the Foxfire Project book. Actually, there's a whole series. This is Appalachian folk magic, but you won't find the words witch or witchcraft in here, okay? This is a folk magic book, an American folk magic book, all right? Now, say that you've spent your first year or so and you're wanting to learn more about the goddess. That really intrigues you, the whole history. I mean, the goddess herself, as we know it, is 40,000 years of history with really strong evidence going back even further. And some of our fringe scientists will go back into the 100,000 years. With an academic, we say 40,000. But I want to learn about the goddess. I want to know more. So we are going to be looking for books and this is actually one of my most favorite books. And if you can, it goes through the history of the goddess statues and what their symbology is. It tells where all these cute, like the Willendorf statue. If you see on the shelf up behind me, you can see all the different god and goddess statues across there. This explains them. And nowhere in here is witchcraft, witch, any of that, okay? Starting to see what I'm saying here? All right, you spent your first formulative years, and now you're like, where's my advanced book? I like learning about all of the foods, the herbs, the energies of plants. Then you would probably be interested in something like this, and which really gets into how plants, the foods that hurt us, you know, foods that harm, foods that heal. Just like everything, there's balance. Again, the word witch or witchcraft isn't in this book, but this is all about kitchen witchery right here. This is the best kitchen witchery book you can find. All right, now you're wanting to learn more about, again, back to the gods and goddesses. And wanting to really deepen a relationship and learn to be able to tell stories of them. And y'all are going to laugh at me, but I swear, I'm going to tell y'all, this is a good book. The Idiot's Guide to Classical Mythology. This is going to talk a lot about those different gods and goddesses, their aspects, tell their stories in a very clear and concise way that most people can understand. Guess what again? The word witch and witchcraft is not in this book, okay? And depending on where, if you are up in the tarot, then you're probably going to want to learn more about astrology, more about the zodiac. Now, if you're like me, and you finish those first couple of years and you're like, well, I want to know the roots of magic. I want to know the history of witchcraft, traditional witchcraft. And Carlo Ginzburg, Ecstasy of Witches. The academia will snub their nose but won't quite say no, because Carlo really does lay out the history of witches just through time. It's a great book, but this is more of something you would want to dive into after you've gotten comfortable with who you are. For me, as I am just a scholar, academic, forever student of magic type witch, for me I wanted to know more about the occult, that the principles of magic, the quantum physics of it, if you speak. And so for me, one of the things I was wanting to get up into was the three books of occult philosophy, which is the basis of ritual magic. All right. Your advanced books are based on what you're interested in. All right. That's why there is no one advanced witchcraft for everybody book, because that book would be the size of several libraries, because that's what our advanced books are, the libraries of the world. All right. Wherever your interest lies, take it to the next step. All right. And learn more about it and put more depth in what you're doing. And at the same time, if you're not drawn to any of these books, you're out there doing your magic, you have your connection to divinity, to the goddess, God, all right, then don't worry about these books. You don't need them, okay? The advanced part is getting out every full moon and doing it. Experience. All right. When you get out there every full moon, you do it for a year and a day. You make a commitment to yourself and to divinity as you know it, that you are going to go out there every full moon and connect to those energies. All right, and at the end of that year and a day, you will be a different witch, okay? And this doesn't mean you got to get out there every full moon and get all... It's as simple as lighting a candle and taking those deep breaths, connecting to what's around you, letting divinity know that you're open to whatever it has to offer, all right? So our advanced books are... everything, okay? Because witches are interested in everything. Every type of witch there is, all right? So celebrate what you're doing, okay? And don't worry about these books if they're not drawn to you, okay? If you're doing you and feeling good about it, then you are doing it the right way. I promise ya. All right. And as I think I talked more than enough for today, I want to thank y'all for joining me here. So amazed at all of the folks that are becoming part of the House of Witchcraft. We got lots of rooms in the house, so please join us and hit that subscribe button. Thank you so much. Have a bright, blessed day. And as always, amen, blessed be, ashe, and avobo.